just recusing.
Were you not above board before this even occurred with everyone on the board?
Yes, always. D, ZA 3551, coming First United Methodist Church.
I have not received any comments of any kind about this. My only concern originally was the sewer, but it's a tiny little building for a food bank, and it's not like there's going to be a bunch of people there, so septic, I think, is fine. And sewer would be not cost-effective for them at all, so.
I wrote down, looked at it, it looked like a perfect spot for what they want.
Yeah, and they'll be moving the food bank that they now have inside the church.
The church to this building.
It should be very beneficial for people who make use of this, so.
Any other questions? G, ZA 3555, the Villas at Canterfield LLC.
In your folder, you had an insert sheet that took your, this was the one where they tried to clean up the variances a little bit. They were confusing, still a little confusing, but not as much as they were.
Is this the variance for the driveway? That adjoins the parking lot of the church?
And what draws the loop in it is senior housing has its own setback separate from anything else. So what Emory and them staff tried to do was they tried to make it, it got muddled simply because you have to apply for variance to the commercial or senior housing, or does one overlap the other one? So but the main thing is, the variance is to the side where the driveway is, and the church wants to use the driveway, so there's really not a problem with the variance.
I've not heard anything derogatory about the zoning at all. I think the public meetings and everything, there was not really anything that needed to be addressed.
Any questions? Do you want to update Matt?
I'm sitting here trying to talk about the Riverbrook thing.
Well,
I think that we've solved the open meeting thing.
Get the rules of the right.
Okay, I think we need to make sure that we follow the rules and the regulations that are set out by the state. The problem, if we don't do that, and it hasn't been done in the past, is that it could come back and bite us, and actually invite the Board of Commissioners, if it's not done right.
And they can make us. Right.
Is this the state's rules?
No, this is our own stuff. This is put out, and so this is the other thing.
So, do we have a copy of the state's rules?
Don't you have one of these? Yeah, I've got the rule. I can bring that up. Yeah, but let me tell you a little bit about this, because y'all haven't. I'm going to stay away from the other. This was put out in 2000, so this has been around for a while. And it was written by Ken Girard, and it tells you how you're supposed to conduct yourself when you have a conflict of interest. Our own attorney has said that what we've done is wrong. We all got a letter saying it's wrong. The Common Cause says that it's unethical, not to go by this, and possibly illegal. It's a misdemeanor.
I didn't get a letter about that. I got a letter about the sunshine laws.
No, you didn't get a letter about this, but I'm talking
about.
You
just said we all got a letter about it.
No, I meant the
sunshine
law.
Yeah.
The letter from Ken Girard was about the open meetings.
Right.
Okay, and as far as I'm concerned, I think we all pretty well understand that. Did you get one of these?
I probably had it. You have no idea how much paper I go through.
Did you get one?
I don't recall having that, but.
Well, that tells us how we're supposed to act.
Yeah.
It maybe wasn't in a binder.
It keeps Lydia off of our rear end.
It maybe wasn't in a binder, it maybe was in that packet, and I read it right in the beginning.
Really?
It's the kind of document, I wouldn't expect anyone to read and memorize, but more read it and say, you know, the next time that comes up, I'm familiar with it, and I know to turn to it.
Yeah.
But you're not, I don't expect anyone to.
That's one of the points I'm trying to make is.
I read all of that information, so my inclination is that I didn't feel a need to study it.
I mean, that, what we do, that just ends here, and if we.
It's just like anything else, Jody, anything we say or anything we do has ramifications down the road.
But if we mess it up, then they could come back and cost the county a whole lot of money. You know, and that's why we need to follow the rules and do it right so that we are above reproach.